Hey everyone. So when you're a content creator, there's a couple of things that you have to be very careful about when making content online. There's a whole multitude of different things that you have to be aware of, but one of the main things is copyrighted content. Now, copyrighted content could be something that you are doing yourself, in which you make a piece of content that is copyrighted from someone else. For example, if you get a music video and you just strip it down and you take the music and you put it on your channel, that's copyrighted, and the company that owned the rights to that piece of music can actually file a copyright claim. Now, this is important because when you file a copyright claim, or you have a copyright claim filed against you, it can be disastrous for your YouTube channel, because if you get 3 copyright strikes, that's it. You cannot make another channel. Your channel gets deleted and you're in a bit of trouble. But not only can it affect your YouTube stuff, you can actually get into a lot of legal trouble when you're making copyrighted material, because if somebody owns the rights to the song and you've made a lot of money on it by using that copyrighted material, then they can sue you. It goes on your record that you have been sued and that you have lost the case, and you can pay out a lot of money. Now, I've been in a situation where I personally have had to file a copyright claim on someone else. And this was on Facebook, when somebody just made an advertisement of a product for Lucid Dreaming that used primarily my entire video. So they used my video from YouTube to advertise a product using their own website. And I thought, you know, if they used a few clips, then it's fine, but they pretty much using me as the whole driving narrative of this video. And it was on Facebook. I filed a copyright claim. I actually got in contact with the chap first, and they said, it doesn't matter. He had some backwards response for me. And I thought, well, fine, I'll just file a copyright claim. 5 minutes after the copyright claim was filed, he came back to me saying, sorry, please. And I was like, no, I gave you the chance to, you know, do something else, and you didn't do it. I've also been on the other side of that, where a company has filed a copyright claim on me, in which I put a song in one of my videos, which was Double Rainbow on the Way Across the Sky. Yeah, so intense. So that song. And somebody tried to file a copyright claim on me. Now, I used just the right amount of that song for it to be not copyrighted, pretty much. It was a little small segment, put it in my video. And the company, who, by the way, didn't own the music, came to me, filed a copyright claim, and I had to file a counter claim to them as well. So that I said, yeah, fine, if that's the case, if you find that it is copyrighted, that's fine. I don't mind paying however much this thing makes. But if you're going to copyright the entire video because of 5 seconds worth of song, I'm not going to give you that. I'm going to give you 5% of 50%, 50% being video and audio. I said, I'll give you 5% of the audio creditation. So if I was to make, let's say, £100 on that video, then I would say, well, £50 is video, £50 is audio, so audio is £50. And then 5% of that would be £2.50. That's what I said. And then I counter-claimed it, and I won, because obviously. But then I'm looking around YouTube Studio at the moment, and I was actually quite shocked, because there's a subcategory called copyright, and I don't use Studio Beta. I've only ever used the classic Creator Studio, because I prefer it, to be honest. But I just had a look around the Studio Beta version, and there's this subcategory called copyright. And when I went onto the copyright section, I found a list of videos that were copyrighted. And I didn't know too much about this, because I wasn't particularly clued up on what this actually is. It turns out YouTube automatically detects whether your videos have been used on other channels, and it also gives you a percentage of how much of your content is used on those videos. So this one here says 100% of my video is used as their video. Okay, that's a bit alarming for me as a content creator. These views are very small compared to my videos, but that's not really the point. The point is, when you're trying to protect your brand and protect you as a content creator, copyright is huge, because this may seem like a very small, insignificant amount, but if somebody gets like 50 million views from one of your videos, then you're entitled to all of it, because it's your content if all of your content was used. So I had a look at this and I was quite shocked, because first and foremost, I don't ever remember getting an alert for this. And if I'd have stuck on Creator Studio Classic, I would have never have seen this. It says 80% match, but when I looked at these videos, I saw that it wasn't 80% match. It is 100% on all of these. So this one is a live stream, which is 3 hours long, that I did once. So that's an indication as to the severity of this. Why do people fail at lucid dreaming? That is 100% of mine. How long is a lucid dream? 100% mine. And the same for this one. I actually missed that Nintendo DS. So I'm quite shocked, to be honest, because it's not just them copying my videos. It's them stripping my video from my channel and uploading it exactly. If they used it in some artistic manner, like I know some people have used a lot of my videos to suggest like critiques or commentary on stuff. There was one of my subscribers who is a really nice chap, and I can't remember for the life of me what his name is, so I apologize, but you'll know who you are. He said that the layers of lucid dreaming were not a scale system for lucidity, because, you know, X, Y, and Z. So, fine, I like that. He's using my video to counteract a point that I made. So what am I going to do with these? Well, I'm going to request the removal. I'm going to give a schedule to send a 7-day notice, because if they want to avoid a copyright strike, then I would rather do that. However, looking at this channel, I don't know if any of these are theirs. And I'm going to hazard a guess to say, no, they're not. See, I don't know what to do, because it looks to me like this is just content that they've just stripped from other content creators. It doesn't look like any of this is their own. So should I feel bad that I'm stripping away their channel? I mean, I shouldn't. Nevertheless, let's just double check that all of them are copyrighted. Yeah, see, this isn't theirs. I'm going to go for standard. Cool. So that's that. That's the process that I had to go through to ensure that copyrighted material doesn't appear on other people's channel. It's not something that I want to do, by all means. Like, I wish people just would use their brain and not have copyrighted material on other people's channels, but that's the way it is at the moment. Now, the downside of me doing that, there isn't one. As long as I check to see that the content that I posted has been stripped wholeheartedly, then I am safe and guilt-free from any responsibility, because it's their responsibility to not copyright my stuff. It's their responsibility to not copyright anyone else's stuff. It could have been an accident, but that's why I went through all the channels to see if their content that they created on their channel was actually theirs, and I don't think any of it was. So if it was somebody who had loads of content that was, you know, theirs, and then suddenly it was mine, then yeah, I would do a scheduled 7-day posting so that they know that that's mine, so that they can avoid a copyright strike. because I know what it's like to be a content creator, and I'd hate to have a copyright strike. But yeah, it's just a weird position you find yourself in. And I think the weirdest thing about this whole thing was that copyright stuff wasn't popped up to me. I didn't have a notification. I didn't get sent an email. I didn't have anything like that. I just had to look for it. And that's quite concerning. So that's it for this video. It's a bit different from what I'm usually used to making. But sometimes you just got to see the insides and the workings behind the scenes of content creation. So until next time, bye!